As the 1992-93 season opened, the University of Cincinnati was truly an enigma to the college basketball scene. The Bearcats were coming off one of the most successful seasons in the school's proud basketball history, a school record 29 victories and a trip to the NCAA Final Four. Back for an encore performance were six seniors, all of whom played major roles in last year's success. But there were some big questions. How would the Bearcats replace their top two scorers? Herb Jones and Anthony Buford had been the go-to guys during that successful campaign. And the eligibility. A veteran center, Corey Blunt, was in question, with a 6'10 pivot not expected to be available until mid-January at best. The nation's college basketball experts were divided on the Bearcats' prospects. Cincinnati was ranked as high as ninth by one publication, but didn't make the top 50 in another. UC was picked to finish anywhere from first to fourth in the Great Midwest Conference. One group which harbored no doubts was the Cincinnati players. They remembered clearly how the previous year's team had set lofty goals, then accomplished those objectives in journeyman's fashion. Not to be outdone, the current Bearcats set equally high goals for 1992-93. There was little question that Nick Van Exel would be the one to inherit the go-to role. The 6'1 point guard wasted little time showing that he could be a scoring leader as well as direct the offense when he recorded a 21-point effort in the season opener against Texas Southern, an 87-44 win. Van Exel also demonstrated his mental toughness and desire to play. Following the season opener, damage was discovered in the cartilage in his left knee, and arthroscopic surgery was performed on December 4th. 8 days later, he was back on the court to aid the 91-57 win over Georgia Southern. After serving in a six-man capacity the previous year, Eric Martin showed that he was capable of becoming a dominant force on the front line. He scored a career-high 19 points in the opener. Then 10 days later, bettered that with 23 points and 9 rebounds in UC's 83-58 win over Southeast Missouri. He was hands-down choice as the MVP of the Delta Bearcat Classic. The Bearcats won their first three contests by an average of 34 points and steamed into their mid-December clash with fourth-ranked Indiana, scoring a whopping 87 points per game. The Hoosiers cooled UC, but not Van Exel, who tallied 22 points in the 79-64 loss. A week later, before a nationwide television audience, Van Exel put on a shooting exhibition to spark Cincinnati's 68-45 rout of Temple. Nick drilled a school record 8 three-point field goals en route to a 26-point performance. UC's hounding pressure defense also drew acclaim, limiting the Owls to 30.4% shooting from the field. Following a 65-55 win over area rival Dayton, the Bearcats scored lopsided victories over South Alabama and Tennessee. Alan Jackson, who had been asked to play out of position as the team's point guard the previous two seasons, returned to his natural off-guard spot. AD's confidence soared, allowing him to score in double figures in 5 of the first 8 games, capped by a season-best 18 in the South Alabama win. He also set a standard for consistency, the only Bearcat to play in every regular season game. Another Bearcat who made a major contribution to the team's fast start was sophomore Curtis Bostic. The 6'5 sophomore, who missed all but the first 3 games the previous year after undergoing back surgery, was a double-digit scorer in 8 of his first 9 games, highlighted by a career-high 20 points against the Volunteers.
Mark, first half, here's the alley-oop!
After playing 6 of its first 8 games at home, Cincinnati embarked on a 4-game road swing and returned 2 weeks later with 4 victories. Van Exel's 27 points sparked a 64-53 victory over 22nd-ranked Massachusetts, and the senior followed that with a 22-point performance in an 80-65 win over St. Louis. Lazelle Durden came off the bench for his first college double-digit scoring performance, netting 13 points in a 72-63 win at Cleveland State. By mid-January, the Bearcats were 10-1, despite having no regular player taller than 6'6". Then came the good news the team had anxiously awaited. The NCAA restored the eligibility of Corey Blunt on a Saturday afternoon, and the Bearcats celebrated with a 70-64 win over nemesis DePaul on Saturday night. Blunt wasted little time reestablishing his presence, hitting a basket in his first minute of action. At 11-1, Cincinnati climbed into the top 10 of college basketball's rankings for the first time in 16 seasons, as Associated Press made the Bearcats their number 9 team, and USA Today CNN gave UC the 8th spot. Defense continued to be a key. UC held 6 of its first 12 foes to under 40% shooting from the field and was ranked among the nation's top 4 in scoring defense. The Bearcats put on an offensive clinic to go with their usual stringent defense for a 103-43 win over Chicago State. The team's depth became evident as the bench bunch scored 60 points. That offensive firepower was cooled by Alabama-Birmingham as the Blazers deployed a deliberate slow-down style of play to create a defensive struggle. Van Exel lifted the Bearcats from a 1-point deficit to a heart-stopping 40-38 win when he recovered a loose ball and then fired it in from 3-point range at the buzzer. This year's edition of the annual Crosstown Clash with Xavier was billed as a battle between Cincinnati's perimeter attack and Xavier's inside game. Van Exel fulfilled his role, his half-court basket among his 15 points.
Shot clock at 6. Gentry forced the issue. Rebound to Martin. Throw ahead to Van Exel. He'll cut it loose. Watch out!
Eric Martin and Corey Blunt turned the tables on the Muskies with their dominant inside play. They helped UC score 14 of its 23 baskets from inside the paint while controlling the boards in the 78-69 win. The Bearcats' reign as city champs continued. UC extended its win streak to 12 with an 80-54 clubbing of DePaul and moved into fourth place in both major national polls, its highest ranking in 29 years. Facing a Miami of Ohio team determined to score an upset, Cincinnati got a career scoring high 22 points from sophomore Lazelle Durden, who came off the bench to score 15 in a row in the first half. Van Exel sent the game into overtime with a layup in the final 50 seconds, then opened the extra period with a tray and was 6-for-6 at the foul line in the 74-68 overtime win. After a 98-61 victory over Austin Peay, UC's win streak had reached 14, tops in the nation. But Memphis State was determined to end the skid of 4 straight losses to the Bearcats suffered the previous season. Cincinnati fought back from a 13-point deficit in the final 13 minutes 49 seconds to take a 1-point lead. But the Tigers recovered in a 68-66 win. The setback, UC's first in 2 months, dropped the Bearcats into second place behind Marquette in the Great Midwest Conference standings. And the Red Hot Warriors, on a 10-game winning tear, were the Cats' next challenge. With a score tied at 53 and time running out, a heavily guarded Van Exel found Martin free under the basket with a seeing eye pass, and Martin laid the ball in just before the buzzer sounded.
Van Exel, they look down low to Martin, and it's over! Bearcats win it!
Corey Blunt worked himself into midseason shape quickly upon having his eligibility restored. Blunt, who had scored a career-high 20 points in his second outing of the year against Chicago State, led UC's attack with 19 points in a 64-39 win over St. Louis. 4 days later, He scored 17 points in the 72-50 victory at South Florida. Over a five-game period, Blunt averaged 15.8 points and 9 rebounds. His greatest impact may have been on the defensive end, where he blocked nearly 2 shots a game. The late February showdown of 2 top 10 teams in the 7-up shootout found Arizona neutralizing Blunt and the rest of the UC front. Van Exel outscored the rest of his teammates with 31 points as UC fell to a 70-60 loss to the 4th-ranked Wildcats. Cincinnati visited Marquette in another battle for first place in the Great Midwest. The Bearcats rallied from a 4-point halftime deficit, playing perhaps their finest 20 minutes of basketball in the second half. Van Exel scored 20, while Terrence Gibson, the team's 6th man, scored 8 of his 12 points in the final 7 minutes to ice the 66-59 victory. Injuries helped UAB score a 67-60 upset victory in Birmingham. Van Exel put on another shooting demonstration, scoring a career-high 33. But no other Bearcat reached double figures. The setback set up a season-ending clash with Memphis State for the regular season league title. Before a sellout crowd and with emotions riding high from senior night, the Bearcats raced to a 20-point lead at various stages in the first half, en route to a 78-55 win. Van Exel and Martin each scored 21 points, with Blunt contributing 15 points, 10 rebounds, 3 block shots, and 4 steals. The win gave Cincinnati its second straight Great Midwest Conference regular season title and completed a 22-4 regular season record, thus fulfilling 2 of the Bearcats' preseason goals and putting them in a position to attack the other. The team's next objective was the Great Midwest Conference Tournament. Nick Van Exel exploded for 30 points to lead the Bearcats to a 78-69 victory over DePaul. That set the stage for a championship game rematch with host Memphis State. UC jumped out to an early lead, but the Tigers, sparked by All-American Anthony Hardaway's determined play, came back in the second half. Memphis State seems to bring out the best in the play of Eric Martin. Martin, who had scored 21 points a week earlier against the Tigers to clinch the regular season title, exploded for career highs with 25 points and 14 rebounds in the 77-72 victory. Terry Nelson played a large role as well. Nelson, the team's defensive specialist, stepped up his play at the offensive end of the court during the tournament. The senior then turned in the defensive gem of the championships when he drew this charging foul on Hardaway in the closing minute, with UC leading by a point to seal the win. The Bearcats, who were bent on establishing national respect the past 2 years, got that respect when the seedings for the NCAA tournament were announced. Cincinnati was seeded 2nd in the East Regional, its highest placement ever. UC lived up to that building with a pair of one-sided victories in the first and second round games. Just about every Bearcat got into the scoring column in the 93-66 opening round win over Coppin State, with freshman Keith Greger and John Jacobs enjoying shining moments of their own. Putting a damper on the celebration was the injury to Alan Jackson, who suffered a cartilage tear in the game and would be sidelined for the remainder of the tournament. Jackson's loss meant a promotion to the starting lineup for Terrence Gibson, and the senior, known for his defensive prowess, responded by scoring a career-high 25 points in the 92-55 victory over New Mexico State. UC's vaunted defense played such havoc that at times the Aggies didn't know who to pass to.
Zip one underneath. It was caught by Reed at the free throw line. That pass was intended for Tracy Ware.
Cincinnati advanced to the Sweet 16 for a matchup with Virginia. Corey Blunt and Eric Martin pounded Virginia's taller front line for 34 points and 23 rebounds. Blunt showed his prowess at both ends of the court, blocking this shot and then finishing the play at the other end with this dunk.
Whoa! Van Exel.
Nick Van Exel erupted from a scoring slump for 19 points and dished out a career-best 11 assists. For the second straight year, the Bearcats were in the Elite Eight, where they met North Carolina. Nick Van Exel gave the Tar Heels a shooting lesson, drilling 6 3-pointers in the first half as UC led by as many as 15.
Here's Van Exel. Beyond the white line.
Good spacing here by Cincinnati. They'll spread you out and try to beat you off the dribble.
North Carolina rallied, using its superior size inside to close the gap before the half, and a classic game was on.
That'll hurt you too.
Montross.
Terrence Gibson tied the game after recovering the loose ball with this layup to send it into overtime. The taller and deeper Tar Heels prevailed in the extra period, 75-68, and went on to win the national championship. The 1992-93 season closed with a 27-5 record, the fifth best in school history. The curtain was brought down on a two-year run in which the Bearcats had won 56 of 66 games, won two conference championships, made two trips to the Sweet 16, and an appearance in the Final Four. The national respect that the team had been driven to achieve over the past 2 years had been earned by hard work and overachievement. Once again, Cincinnati basketball ranked among the nation's elite.
Second call, Van Exel, they look down, Lotus Martin, and it's over!